I hear you, and I understand that's your view.
Anybody else have any questions, comments for him? Board was looking, we was going to get $150,000 home on each one, so we're going to be losing $100,000 in taxable asset and property tax.
Property tax.
So, you know, if you take that over a 20-year span, what are you going to lose? You know, and that was the whole purpose, I think, of the program is one, you know, building new homes, but two, to increase the tax base. So I think this board needs to look at what it's losing tax base by losing that lot to build a new home on over at least a 20-year period.
When do you plan on starting on the house?
My builder has told me that he could start in 45 to 50 days.
Can we ask who the builder is?
Yeah, right now I'd rather hold off. My architect, his name is Greg Staley, and he's in Northern Kentucky, and he may in fact be the builder as well. If not, he has someone else. So I'll tell you, there's someone else, he's not sure yet. Fair enough. But it will either be Greg Staley or one of his people.
But this will be started within a certain amount of time?
He assures me I can be in there before.
How is it going to be?
Well, let me ask you. Let me answer it this way. He's assured me that I can be in the house and completed in November, by November. So yeah, he would start pretty quick, Mr. Rogers.
It's all going to really depend on the zoning and anything he has to do through our planning commission too, I would assume, or just with the zoning department. No.
But I would assume you wouldn't have a issue of signing an agreement that they'd be a completed home within 6 months, 7 months, yeah. Some period.
I would do that provided there's a proviso in case there was extenuating circumstances that I couldn't do it.
Just because another
that you
issue
were made aware of.
You know, we got. I think we got some issues out there. 12 months, and it's way exceeded on property.
Mr. Lawrence, I would be glad to sign that, provided that as long as I keep you posted on any extenuating problems. Fair enough.
Weather
being one of those.
Okay.
Tony, thank you.
So would you still be interested even if you're not eligible for the grant?
Well, I would probably say I'd like to adjust my offer a little bit. But well, so do you share Mr. Lawrence's opinion on that?
Well, I do understand we're giving up two homes.
I understand.
For one. And that's where there might be some adjustment.
Can I take 1 second and turn around?
You got to ask the boss.
She didn't say no, so Mary and I would agree to that. But that's how we work, and I can't do it without her, so.
I don't know why he wouldn't be eligible. It would you guys were talking about new construction.
Well, there's actually, we got money put back for these two lots, right, when we set our total amount?
We just, can't remember if we done.
Yeah, we did.
All that, yeah.
So the money's there for them, but.
Yeah, we're going to probably have to do an appropriation to fund this, our current, it was.
We put in 66 or 60 something.
Yeah, I believe it was.
That was to
60.
With the 16 that was already there.
It was 60.
That went to.
We put in 60 with the 16, yeah.
We're going to do an allocation for 60.
Yeah.
Replenish.
I mean, I could understand not giving them 20 because, you know, or I mean, because you guys set up to 15
on
slot.
That's not that exactly.
Paul, can I ask you a couple questions? Because I know in the last meeting it was brought up you had two lots you're going to build a house on. Is that right?
You need this.
Yeah. You heard my feelings about the two lots. I'm just curious, do you have plans on coming to this board and I ask him for that assistance?
No, I'm fine all along. We've talked about it, especially the last two meetings it's been brought up. I've got 2.5 lots over there, and I want to build one house, and your reasoning's fine. I did not plan on it. Personally, I didn't think it was right of me as a builder to come in and ask for it, and with what I possibly might, what I'm running for, I just didn't think it would be right. So I wasn't planning on it.
So the house that you're building on our street, you're not going to apply for the.
Not on our.
No, Tony, this is the one over on the end of Euphemian Canal that I've been saving for myself.
Okay.
Now, the one on Arch Street and the two on Arch Street, the people that will be buying them will be applying for that, yes. Yes.
Thanks.
Oh, I have one other question. As far as your time limits on those, were there any time limits imposed by the board?
Yeah, but it wasn't, guys, in all fairness, it wasn't 6 months.
Yeah.
I think, Tony, and you might know, I think it was 2 years.
Was it, it's just when you finished one, you got another lot. You got three, you got three more lots. You didn't actually put time limits on it.
No, you guys are more into, I mean, if you, I think you should be more into, hey, when you plan on starting, because you know darn good and well when he starts, he's gonna finish. Time limit, you know, I'd like to see you be fair about it, you know.
Well, my only concern is that we're buying these lots, we're buying these blighted places up, and we're spending a lot of money tearing them down, surveying them, getting utilities there and everything. And if we're opening up a can of worms, that people with a little bit more money can come in and buy these lots up double at a time. And again, we started this to get more people downtown and increase our tax base and stuff. I think we're really opening ourselves up to a can of worms, and a house like he's talking about gonna stick out like a sore thumb. It's a nice house and everything, but the area, you know, them people, they try to, some of them are trying to upkeep their homes and stuff over there, keep them up.
I won't argue that point with you, but I will, I have to argue with you, because I think the city has made a lot of bold moves in the last 3 to 4 years to stick out like a sore thumb. And I'm proud that they have. I'm proud that that convention center sticks out like a thumb. People come down, it doesn't fit down there, but it's not about today, it's about tomorrow. And we're not gonna build a house that's futuristic looking. It's gonna be something along the lines of the house that I showed you. And I would hope that there's, when Paul's done with the house that's behind us, that $150,000 is gonna look $25,000 better than the $125,000 house that he's built. And I would hope that when other lots open up after we build, that somebody will say, yeah, I want 3 bedrooms, you know, and I want a 2-car garage, right, and do the same thing. And I don't think that's unfair or unreasonable to assume on my part that if I'm willing to take this risk and build a house that looks like that down there,
well,
it's on across from a pretty park, kitty corner from a beautiful hotel by the casino. And I next to a really wonderful apartment building that the city built 8 years ago or 7 years ago.
Well,
I don't think it's out of line.
I got to go back to when this originated and we agreed to buy these
places. Well, I wasn't arguing that with you.
And what we was going to do with that property. And we're, you know, like I say, we've put a lot of money in it and we've told people what we're doing. We've got this program out there to the public and everything. And we're just getting way off track with people with money coming along wanting to snatch all this up.
Well, I'm not a person with money.
Well,
I have to go to the bank to borrow the money like anybody else does.
But that's the problem comes in, I believe, like I said, because of getting that advantage of that second lot to also be eligible for that $15,000. I don't think that's a fair to everybody else.
I just like to say, in the beginning, this program was for young people out there, whoever, were out there renting, and Lawrenceburg rent rates went up when the boat came in. They were paying anywhere $700, $900 a month. They couldn't save money for a down payment of a house. They could afford to make a house payment, but they couldn't get
the 15 help.
They couldn't get that down payment. So we said, let's help them. You know, we'll give them $10,000. That's what that $10,000 was for. And this is what's going to come up later.
I was here, Tony, when they came. I mean, I remember.
So it was for the people who could not afford to save that down payment up. So,
Tom?
I have a question. This is not about that, but the firehouse. Could you tell me where you guys are on the firehouse?
Oh, let's get this down for you.
Well, my question goes to, you say you're going to start this within 6 months, but I think you told us.
No, I said we're going to finish this within 6 months.
We're going to start the firehouse restaurant. Back in February when we had these meetings, it was supposed to be up and running by now. And my question is, when are you going to fulfill that obligation, I'll say, on the firehouse down here?
Well, I don't have memory of saying that it would be up and running in 6 months. I do remember, no, we can go back and, John, you're here.
Meeting.
Did we say that? It would be up and running in 6 months?
Okay. I didn't say 6 months. It would be up and running by spring or, but we had, remember we had to spay, it was snow, freezing. We had to get this done. It had to be transferred so you could get the people in there so you'd be up and running this summer.
No, it was, that's not my memory. I don't remember ever saying, honestly, and you can run the tapes, but I don't remember ever saying, if John said he did, that's fine, that we had to get these people, we had to get it now for that reason. What was going on at the time was a lot of litigation, and it was complicated litigation, as if Leslie wants to add anything to this. And in order for us to make plans to start getting things done and make some decisions, it would have to be ours, and it would have to be clear, and it would have had to been cleared by this board before they could get the other lawsuits removed. And that's what that was about.
Well, is it going to be up and running this year? Can I ask you that?
John?
Well, I'm the one that, quite frankly, currently owns the firehouse in its entirety. And I've gotten more done in the last 60 days than the $216,000 you guys gave to Tim Denning. And that was, what, 3 years or two?
To Tim Denning.
Whoever went to?
He went to his wife.
His wife. But I'm saying, we've already started working. Tom?
Are you going to be up and running this year?
Probably not. I'm working on it, but now I've got the townhouses I'm working on. We've got the restaurant we're working on.
That's why I asked.
Okay.
That's it. Thank you.
But we are working on it, and we will continue to work on it and improve that property.
Thank
we
you.
Already have, so.
You mentioned the townhouse. How long has it been on the townhouse?
It's been a little over a year. I didn't have a time requirement on that, so.
A year?
No, it was not. And the question keeps on getting asked, I wish it was just end, because we were going to finish it. We're in the process of painting the interior now, that we'll be doing the floors. That was a major reconstruction project. We had floors at a level by 6 inches. Windows were collapsing, chimneys were collapsing, the floors weren't supported. I don't know who was watching over that project. I know it wasn't Carl. But that was a project that, quite frankly, there was a lot of money wasted on those buildings down there. And I think the other buildings are in just as bad shape, but most of that stuff might have been covered up. I don't know how Paul did on his daughters, but we did a lot of to try to save that building for the long term, and we have. And we have put a lot of extra money into it. But we are getting very, very close to finishing all the property, which is why I haven't really spent as much. But we had guys working on the wall down there because the firehouse is ready to collapse. So. I believe in preservation first, and sometimes I wasn't 100% sure what the condition of that particular property was. It was in a lot worse shape than anyone in here probably imagined. Donnie, you saw the condos I had and the shape they were in.
Oh, yeah, I've walked through them.
I mean, but if you go into them now, you won't believe the transformation we have in that place. So.
But I think all that work was done before anybody sitting up here was on board.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to be real proud. I'm going to be happy to show you guys.
In fact, if you want to come down and see it,
Mike, I'd be happy to show it to you. I even got some pictures of some of the before and the after, so you can see some of the issues you're running into. Right. You'll understand why it's taken so long, and a lot of money has been poured into that place trying to fix it up so that we would have the building secured and, quite frankly, ready to.
Well, let us get back to this.
Anyway,
requested.
Tom, I'm going to continue to work on the firehouse. It's going to be done. There's just been a lot of stuff in there I did not anticipate, so I'm committed to it.
All right. Thanks. Let's get back to the house.
When you guys come. To us, when you come to us for these lots, you knew the program we had out there, and I feel you want two lots, so you can have a two-car garage. You know, we never give us opportunity to any of the other people that build on lots and stuff that they could buy two and stuff. I just think we're opening up a can of worms, and it's just we ought to stick to our guns. One lot.
Grant, what year was it that we actually bought all those from?
2012.
And it's 15. And this is the first time I know that anybody's been interested in the Center Street lots.
And they should have been advised.
Our board's going to discuss this. It's not the attorney's decision on this matter.
I know it's not a decision. I was just asking when the timeframe was.
Hold on.
One thing I'd like to ask, Mr. Dennis. So are you interested, if you're not eligible for the grants, are you still interested in this property?
In two lots.
Yeah, very much.
Or would you rather do one lot and be eligible for the grant?
I want to build a nice home there that I'm comfortable in. And to answer your question, Tony, yes, I would.
Owen, do you have anything?
Well, I was just thinking about, it seems like we have some ambiguity written or not written into the agreements, which is causing some confusion. So the comment that I have is, Paul's got three lots, 2.5 lots down there that you want to build a home on. If Paul had come before us and said, hey, I've got these lots down here that I'm going to be building a home on for an individual, would we have withheld the $15,000 at that point? I'm just asking a question. Would we have withheld that if we had a contractor come in here that was a contractor that wanted to do the same things that Paul's doing, buy the Arch Street lots, build this home, taking the risk, hoping he could sell it to somebody, and he came and said, I want to build both lots. Will you still give the $15,000 to a new home buyer or someone coming in to buy that lot? Would we have extended that $15,000 to that buyer? That's what I'm concerned about is we've got Dennis asking for the home, but if Dennis were a contractor here wanting to build a home, would we withhold that $15,000? I don't know that we would. And so I'm just afraid that we're, look, the end result is the same. There's a home there. And I'm afraid that we're not being consistent in our approach. That's my only concern. I don't know that we're being consistent. I know there was anticipations, and all this stuff happened before me, anticipations of having certain number of homes down there and things like this, but I think we've already changed from the number of homes that were down there and made the lots bigger, right? I mean, there were 33s, and now they're 42s or something. So I think we probably understood that there wouldn't be exactly the same number of homes going back in there. We had some idea. So I just want to make sure that we're being fair in our approach. And that's my only comment.
So, Owen,
we did
you don't – hold on. So you don't think that it should matter, you know, if when it was looked at? Because, actually, I think this board voted on there being 5 homes, I'm pretty sure, at one time there, if I remember correctly. When
we originally got that property, yes, it was 5 homes. But it was an understanding that we were trying to move off that 33-foot lot and get to a 41.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what it worked out on that. And we replatted and subdivided that area to make that happen.
And that's where I come up with the $150,000
home.
Yeah,
but so when I see that, and I can see the side where you're getting a lot and you're getting an additional lot that has a value, right? I mean, the lot has a value. And is that value, basically, is it a push? Is the $15,000 credit we're going to give you and the value of a lot, do they offset each other, and is that a push? I mean, I can see that side of it, too. I just don't know that we, I mean, I haven't seen any documentation, personally. I've asked to be able to read through these things so I could come in here and intelligently comment on it, but I haven't seen any of the agreements saying what the purpose was. And so I feel like I'm at a disadvantage, honestly, commenting on it.
Colin, do you have something?
No, I was just going to comment on, yes, there was 5 buildings, and we broke it down to 4 houses. I think them lots in the 4 are big enough to handle a home you was wanting to put on each one of them.
May I comment on Olin's question,
yep,
please? Or his comment? That's the problem I see as well, consistency. We did go back through the minutes of, I mean, I went back all the way to 2009. Well, and what was presented to you all tonight was the ones we could, I mean, the very first one was done in 9/23/09, and those were all the Fox Drive properties. So we went back to the minutes to see, and, you know, there is mention when Mr. Steidel was the city manager, he brought up the home, and it was Home Buyers Assistance Program. And it was, you know, from that time, there was nothing that gave us any kind of guidance as to what the criteria are. I mean, they're, like Tony said to begin with, at our first meeting on when we started to talk about this, and I think Mr. Waltz's request, those are the people that we're going to have to talk to as far as what they remember what the redevelopment did, because it's not in the minutes.
Well, Leslie, your mind is surely still fresh about these four lots. We talked about four.
Oh, yeah, I'm not talking about the four lots, but to go to his point was...
And
was
I said
the,
five.
The
I
policy. The policy, you know, there is no written policy on the criteria for this home buyer's assistance program.
But on this list that you give us, I believe if you go back and look, every one of those was a brand new home.
I couldn't tell you that.
Huh?
Or a new condo.
Or a condo.
Okay, so let me get one thing clear. When you say five homes, was that on Center Street, or was that on Center and
five,
Arch?
I said five, but I meant four.
Yeah, okay, four. Is that on Center and Arch, or just Center Street?
No, those four lots are.
Total four.
Yeah, total four.
Total of four, Center and Arch.
Yep.
So we're going from four homes to what would be?
Three.
Three. You're building two, right, Satch? And you're building one, so we're losing one home. Okay.
I mean, if the board wants to put these things down in writing, I think that would be a wise decision. As far
nice
as the criteria.
If it had been in writing in 2009.
True.
We really, Satch hadn't come before us about the getting the lots for his personal home over there. I mean, we just keep opening up can of worms, people. Just boom. You've come in front of this board.
Come up, podium.
We're tying too many things together.
Well, my thought is I'd hate to see people with money start moving to Lawrenceburg. That would be my first thought. I think the only question here is, and I think the only want would be to, I would just want to make sure the house got built and the house was what y'all wanted to see there. I do understand the point about you would like to see two homes. I do understand that you are losing a little bit, electric bill, utility bill, taxes, so on, but you might start something too. You might help Mr. Brooks. His house appraised for what, $59,000 when he had the old junk beside him? It might appraise for $79,000 after this new house is built. I think there would be some benefit to that, to the whole neighborhood. The key is making sure it got done the way you wanted to do it. Guys, we've tried, as far as opening up a can of worms, if you're going to give up the two lots and not give the benefit of the $15,000, my buyers, out of 27 people that's bought homes from me, I think it's safe to say that three or four of them never needed the help. You take that offer of that $10,000 away from 24 of my people, well, 27 of them wouldn't have bought a house in Lawrenceburg if that wasn't gave to them. So I don't think you're opening up a can of worms if you're asking him to forfeit this and he's willing to build a house of that caliber in town. I'd have to think about that pretty hard. You know, that's something that you might want catching on, maybe.
Now, what do you feel about the giving up the assistance if you get two lots? Because take every house you build over there, if the people had the choice of, hey, I could have built that house on two lots or one, I'm sure everybody would pick two.
You're right, but as soon as you said that if you take that second lot, you don't get the $10,000. none of my buyers would have took that second lot.
For sure.
Not a one of them.
Wasn't out there.
But I mean, do you think that's too much to ask not to get that assistance if you get the second lot?
That's between you and Mr. Hutchins. That I don't know. But I'm just throwing it out there. The key here is making sure you get what you want at the end of the day. And that's no different than me. You know, I think that we've held a fairly decent standard what we can on these homes. You know, we put a little brick on them, we've tried to do what we can, but we've been fighting a battle of 33-foot lots. And you know, just so you know, the lots at the corner of Canal and Euphemia, they're not a full depth, and they're cut real short on that third lot. But it's something you guys need to think about and know. That's my point.
Thank you, Paul. Dennis, do you have more?
No, I wanted to say thank you to Paul for not accepting answering a question about what he thought you guys should do for me, and leaving it up to him. It should be up to this board. And I appreciate you not answering that, Paul.
Well, I didn't ask him how we should.
I'm just, yeah.
He thought it was fair enough.
Yeah, that's it's fine.
Anything else from the board?
Well, I just want to say we're giving up smaller homes for a nicer home. Lawrenceburg's houses are packed right next to each other. I mean, this could be a set of trend of setting some things apart. Higher price homes, whether that's better or not better, I don't know.
Well, I can tell you guys that my house is going to be taxed at a much higher rate than any
one or two
homes that are going to be.
All kinds of people building a $500,000 home over here would be great. But
well, I'm not going to do that, but I can also tell you that I'm probably going
to do. But I mean, I would never say that's too nice a home.
But I'm saying we're having the opportunity to make it happen. I'm all for selling the lots with the understanding of one grant. Of course, you don't get two grants for two lots, but one house, one grant.
I wasn't even going to propose that to me.
And give us a start date.
Well, there's somebody sitting in the room that hasn't gotten back to me yet, so and I have to talk to my architect. So we'll see how that goes, right?
So could we table this? And so I'd like some more time to think about this. This is just given to me tonight.
I understand, but my wife and I, Mary just came up and said if we can't get a decision, maybe we just need to move on. And I understand if there's problems or if there's dilemmas. Donnie seems to have a serious issue with this about opening a can of worms. And
you know, I'm not against the house.
I wouldn't say a word,
house.
Donnie.
I'm worried about how we did everybody else. If we're going to buy these blighted places and tear them down and put all this money in, everything, you know, we need to make it clear to everybody. You want to buy all the lots?
And I probably wouldn't be there if you hadn't tore them down with the idea. There's several houses in town that I could probably try to buy and tear down, but that's the attractiveness was to me. It was that you had done that.
But all of these
that redevelopment had done that.
All the discussions on these four lots were four houses, and that's what, you know, bothers me. That's what we agreed on, and we get caught varying all the time, and then it always comes back and bites us. Somebody sues us, or I never got the same opportunity. It just turns into a total mess.
It's not they got the same opportunity. If they asked for one lot to build one house on, that's what they asked for. That's what we gave them. This is the first time we've been asked to have two lots to build.
Yeah, Mary and I, to answer Mr. Rogers' question.
Well, this
question
wouldn't be the first time. This would be the second time, right? Because Satch,
he ain't done it yet. Lots are still
sitting. He came and asked a question, and we didn't fight with him about it, did we?
No, he's never. You've never come to us and asked for at one of our meetings.
For those 2.5 lots.
A home over there.
My home. And my opinion. My opinion is, to be frank with everybody here in the room, I've put my money on the line 27 times. I've taken risk. I've gotten loans on these houses. And I've earned the right to build a nice house in Lawrenceburg the way I want to build it. That's how I feel about it. You've got nobody else coming in here doing what I've done. I've went to the bank, I've borrowed money, I've been at risk every time I've built a house of not selling it. Thanks to you guys, every one of them sold. That's my answer.
Yeah, and Donnie, this is a question you asked earlier about, well, what's going to happen when you come to us? Donnie, when Paul decides to build his house, he'll come see me, get a zoning certificate, walk across the parking lot, see Carl, get a building permit. He's going to build the house. I mean, I don't see why he won't come up in front of this board just to build a single-family residence on his own property.
I guess you guys are not following me. I was thinking about back when the deals were made and the lots were laid out and everything, what we all agreed on. That's my problem. That's the only problem I have.
I'm not addressing this new subdivision here.
You know, you can go ahead and you know, you can give them all two lots. But, you know, I would have to vote no, because the original agreement, until, you know, we sit down and we've got new lots out there and we say these lots now, or people can have two of them if they want, and we vote on it, we agree on it. But this always changing in the middle of the streams where I have a problem.
Well, Donnie, I think you're mixing the two of these together. Satch, yours, our original agreement for that subdivision was that you get three lots, you build three homes, get three more lots, build three homes. Was that, and then you got to the last three lots, and we knew there was a problem with those last three lots.
There was a half lot.
And we talked about doing something else, condos or something like that on those last three. But you decided you wanted to build your own home on those lots.
So you're saying that was discussed at a meeting then?
Yeah, in the very beginning, yes. That's the way it was set up.
I'm taking that's what...
Three, and three.
I'm hearing out of Donnie, was it?
Yeah, but we knew there was a problem with the last three lots being small, and we were going to try and do something else with that. But at that time, there was not one new house built in Lawrenceburg, so we wanted to get this program moving, and that's what we did. So now, since then, Satch decided he wants to build his own home in there. I'm not completely against that. I just don't want to mix that up in your feelings with what this man's asking. This man's asking, there's two lots there, he wants to build one home. We had an agreement for four homes, we're going to get three out of those four. We're going to get a nicer home on one of them. I don't think it's that hard.
Well, it ain't hard.
Not to mix, don't put two of them together.
The only two ties I think the two properties has is if one is eligible for the grant, then the other one is. That's the only two ties I see to the two properties.
And I was going to talk about that too. You know, Satch, you brought up a couple of good reasons why you didn't want to take the $10,000. One of them, you're running for office, and you didn't think that would be an appropriate thing. And I probably agree with you there. And it was kind of a personal decision. And this is where I keep coming back to. This is why I hate documents that are not drafted and don't spell things out, because it leaves all these. Everybody's interpretation is different. And I mean, that's my issue with this whole thing is, number one, I haven't seen the document. But number two, the way it's being described, we didn't clarify it. Because I mean, those three lots you have down there, two and a half, you own them, right? Bought them for what, $10 a piece, is that right? Or what is it?
I get $20 for the whole end of town, dollar a piece.
Okay, so let's say for sake of argument, you just came back and said, you know what, I'm going to build... I've got someone who wants that lot, one of those lots, and I'm going to build it on that one and a half. I'm going to build a house there. We still give that person the $10,000, mm-hmm. right? Because we have the flexibility, because nothing's really nailed down in this, we'd have the flexibility to give them the $10,000.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think we're, I mean, if we don't like what's happening, we have the fact that these agreements are not drafted extensively enough to have teeth in it where we have the ability to say no.
I think when it first started out, you was just going to use the one lot and the half lot, and then somewhere along the line it got a little bit bigger. But
a typical lot is...
It does. I mean, it does not say home buyer. And I'll tell you, I think this kind of program is like a first-time buyer program. That's how I see this.
That's what we want.
But it doesn't say that.
Well, it wasn't a first-time buyer program. Matter of fact, when I came in and I put my bid in, I'd just come off the road and I sit in on a meeting. You actually had 4 to 6 other people that said they couldn't build homes on that size lot. Here's what they were going to have to do. They all wanted grants, they wanted money put in the bank, and I stood up and I said, sure, you can build homes on that size of lot. You did it all over town. That's how the town was created. I borrowed my own money, and there was 2 reasons why I got that job. Is because I borrowed my own money, and I told you that we could do it on them size of lots. Those size of lots were 33 feet wide and 132 feet long. Over on the end, there 2 of them that are 33 by 100. The second one that starts curving and it comes in, and the third one is just tremendously, really way back. I mean, I don't even think you could build a garage on it, meet the code. But I guess my point being, bottom line is, guys, is you got to sit back and you got to think, what was there? What was there sitting on the corner? What do you have in front of you? How much is he willing to put into it? I wouldn't have sold one house without your help, not one. And now you've got a potential. And I, you know, hey, I could be against this because here's something, you know, it takes the money from Aurora Lumber. It takes the money from All Right when you don't have 2 houses. But if I didn't know there wasn't 20 other homes in town that we could do this with and this might catch on, that's what gets me excited is it could, and we've been looking for another builder. I mean, how long?
2 years.
Did you get that draft made up? Right?
I want to say one thing, Satch. It's great of you to stand up there and push this, because if he doesn't get these 2 lots, you'll probably end up getting them. And you're willing to give them up yourself.
I'm willing, but
that shows a lot of character.
But I've said we've been looking for another builder. There's enough room here for everybody, guys. And there's more places you can do it in.
I think there was supposed to be some kind of... Did you get something wrote up there, Grant?
I've got a question for Satch. Satch, I have a question for you. What's the average square footage of the homes that you're building?
We have to build 1,300 square foot with the garage, and we've gotten up to about 1,465. And the one for the Joneses is going to be a little over 1,600. So that'll be, and we just set another benchmark. We just sold one for over 150. I didn't think we'd do that. So things are actually it's surprising me. You know, I don't know how many square feet you're looking at, but
19 to 21.
Yeah.
And the only reason I comment on that is, you know, I'm got a house, but I'm looking to either buy or build.
Mm-hmm.
And myself with 5 kids, mm-hmm. if I wanted to be downtown, it wouldn't be an option because, I mean, we're looking 3,500 square foot minimum. And so what you're talking about, having different kind of homes being built down here, I'm not saying I'm for or against what we're talking about specifically, but to have that option to be downtown, because I do like to be downtown.
Well,
I mean, that is something that in the future we ought to be considerate.
Well, here's a good thing for everybody sitting in this chair to think about. We just brought a young professional to town from 1,500 miles away. Going to be here a long time. Do we want him building a home here? Wouldn't we like to have somebody like him want to build a home here?
You don't know my kids.
What's the board want to do on this? As I've heard a couple of things that sounds like maybe should table it and look at some what's in writing. Then I've heard other, sounds like they might be ready to make motions and vote.
I think he made them. Was that a motion you made?
I'd like to see something in writing. I'd like to read all this.
Dennis, can you make a purchase?
Pardon me?
Can you make a purchase agreement up from us? How much you're going to offer for the lots and pretty much what you're going
to
build?
Although well, I'd love to know where we stand on the 15. Is that gone in the board's opinion?
Well, it might be tabled to look at what's in writing. I don't know. What?
Well, I mean, that would be part of the final decision, I guess. But
I think everybody's kind of wanting to see what that original agreement says.
Well, I don't want to delay 1 minute. We have I have a dilemma. It's not your problem, but it's ours. We were actually going to go into 3 Mile, and we had bid on a home up there, a condo up there. And again, I have to tell you this so you understand where I'm coming from. And we've rented our place to somebody else. So Mary and I have to be out of our house shortly, in a couple of months.
Well,
October 1st, we have to be out of our place up there.
Because I think maybe this board can vote on the two-lot deal, well, but not the...
We're motivated to build our house.
I'd still like to wait on the two. I'd like to see a proposal, everything written down, and I'm sorry about October, but...
That's fine, Mr.
We would. I would like to see it, what's in writing, and I wish you the best, but if you choose not to buy, to do this, fine. We'll put two houses there, but I would like to see all this in writing.
Tom, you want to make that an emotion?
I can tell you before you do that that Mary and I are just going to have to pass on the deal if we can't get a decision. And we understand it, and we're adults, and we can take it. But we want to move forward on the lots. And that's why I went to the workshop last week, and that's why I came here today. And if I have to forego the $15,000, I told you I'm willing to do that. But we want to build our home downtown. If we can't, we'll go up to, we'll go somewhere else.
I'd like to see it in writing.
It's fine.
Well, wait a minute.
I'd make a motion. You're willing to forego the $15,000?
Yeah.
I did. I
so
agree
like
with Mr.
Lawrence
that I would
that we sell the two lots to you for the purpose of building this home with the understanding that you will forego the $15,000.
Yes, I told Mr. Lawrence I would do that.
That's my motion.
We have a motion on the floor. Do we have a second?
I'll second.
We have a first and a second. And that was for $800 a lot?
That was per the agreement minus the $15,000 homeowner's purchase.
Is that your understanding? $800 per lot? What?
Well, I think I offered $800 for the two
lots.
Yeah,
two.
Specifically,
I
said.
Okay, so per the agreement without the $15,000.
So $800 for the two lots.
I agree to that.
Hold on. We got a first and a second. More discussion? Go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, Tom's asking for writing, and just, you know, just a few minutes ago, you were
no, Tom's asked for writing, which might blow the deal, and he's willing to give up $15,000, which I thought we all could take an issue.
Yeah, hold on, we're not going to go there, Donnie, because we got a first and a second. Okay. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Wow.
Can I do the roll call?
Yeah, roll call.
Yeah.
I got to think.
Tom Rogers?
Nay.
Olin?
Yay. 4.
Donnie Bryant?
Nay. Against?
Tony Abbott?
Yay. 4.
Before I vote, I want to make sure that there is no way, shape, or form that you can come back and ask and get the $15,000. Because that's going to decide
Mr. Lawrence, I forfeit the program.
Then I'm yes.
Thank you very much.
I tell you, he's a man of his word.
So he's not getting the $15,000.
I thought this was going to be the easy part of the meeting.
He can build his house.
I just hated this. The opportunity wouldn't give to everybody
but,
else. You know?
I was going to say, I think you should make a motion now that by the next meeting, before the next meeting in the packet, you want to get in writing the original agreement so everybody's got it to review.
I would like to.
Or this is no good, right? What Owen's motion was to sell it, unless we get the everything in writing?
No, it's to sell it with the agreement that, like they said, 45 to 50 days to start, $800 for the lots, and they're not getting the assistance, the $15,000 assistance. And they won't come back at a future date for the $15,000 assistance.
Make sure we put the waiver in.
And I would like to...
But I don't know about the 45 to 60 days. Was that part of your motion?
Before you get it in writing.
Okay.
No, there wasn't no time.
Okay, I was just going off what he said, but he's going to build a house very, very shortly.
Something else I'd like to see, too.
Because he's got his place renting.
Coming back is I would like to see us maybe take a run at these documents and getting rid of some of the ambiguity in them so that we avoid these issues.
And that's what I thought there should be. Somebody should make a motion for that to get them so everybody can review them.
What documents? I'm sorry.
So our agreements, do we grant comment?
We need a work session on those, yeah. I would say.
You're okay. The only thing left was from the proposal, which you've accepted the proposal tonight, would be what the house looks like from the outside.
Well, they'll fill in the blanks. I mean, we don't need nothing in writing.
Are you okay with that, or does Dennis need to have that by the next meeting?
Well, I was going off what he says is going to be very similar to this drawing right here. Right?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so,
yeah.
All right.
I did that, Mr. Lunch, so you get an idea of what type of house. And that was Prim's advance.
Well, we could just make sure that it says, according to the proposal, that's $800 paid for the two lots. The two lots on Center Street, a minimum of $200,000 home, 1.5 car garage, one story.
That's a minimum, that's correct.
Do you want to take this and mark amendment pages and let him initial and put it with?
We can.
Is that okay?
Okay.
I didn't hear you.
Have you initial each one of them pages as part of the agreement to the picture?
I'll do it afterwards.
We, as far as any kind of agreement, I mean, the agreement would be binding if we include all of this information in there. So, no.
We have to take off the $15,000 grant program.
Correct. But I do have at the next meeting, I will have a purchase agreement for your review.
And just put if the language in there that if the house design was going to be a major change, you would notify the board.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, if he came back with some crazy architectural drawing, we probably have within our rights to...
Well, that's what we can make sure is in the purchase contract.
Yeah, he shows up with some 70s.
Thanks for giving me that. I didn't have a copy of it. So. Our next...
Leslie Votel, memorandum of understanding with Lawrenceburg Municipal Utilities.
Okay, we also, correct me if I'm wrong, talked about this at the last meeting, and when Mr. Larson was here, the difference that I put in the one that you had prior was I put single phase service in here. So, and I did put approximately $17,000 because I think that was for the single phase.
Yeah, and I've got some added information that the board was interested in knowing on the first meeting and also part of the council discussion we've had.
Look at that.
Had two gentlemen in today working on rate structure and kind of how we're crediting or giving monies to people to come in to do work like this, like Terry Larson's. And so Terry had a concern that if he did single phase to his property, he had another piece of property down below it that he might not be able to sell or something because the customer might not be able to afford to get the three-phase service to it, and that customer might have a need for three-phase service. And so today when I met with these rate design guys, we talked about budget billing, which has been a concern to you. We also talked about establishing some criteria that would build into what I would call a customer credit or customer contribution on the city's behalf, the utility's behalf, where we would regain that initial investment over a period of time, probably 3 years, and that they would have to sign these agreements saying they'll be there for 3 years. So Terry Larson's concern about, well, if you just put single phase to my building, and all he needs is single phase. He cannot use three phase there. He doesn't have a meter for it, doesn't have a service for it. He only needs single phase. If and when someone below him builds three phase, we can then allocate cost or credit towards the construction of that three-phase.
That person would have to come up with a minimal amount of money akin to what Terry Larson's coming up with. And that the whole issue of how we recover those costs has gone away. And Terry's concern is basically put at rest.
Well, let me read the memorandum and you can see whether or not. The memorandum of understanding dated this blank day of June 2015 by and between the Lawrenceburg Redevelopment Commission, the Commission, and Lawrenceburg Municipal Utilities, LMU, for the installation of electric services to 200-300 Industrial Drive, Lawrenceburg, Indiana. The property owner and developer is TKL Property Management, LLC, Terry Larson and Tawny Larson members. The Commission agrees to pay for the installation of the primary single-phase service to the above-stated property at its May 11th, 2015 meeting, provided TKL Property Management pays the first $5,000 for said installation, and any new tenants on the above-stated property also reimburse the Commission its prorated share upon signing a lease or purchase agreement with TKL Property Management. The cost for said service is approximately $17,000 to be payable to LMU upon completion of the installation and approval by the Commission. That's acceptable to what you were just saying?
Yeah, that's acceptable.
Okay. So I just ask, I get a motion to go ahead and...
We get a copy.
Do you have a copy for everybody for that?
We did at the last meeting. Like I said, the only thing I put in there was single phase, and we put in 17,000. So.
Yeah. Do we have a motion?
So moved.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
First and second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. All right. Move on, Leslie, to rescinding a previous motion.
Okay. I wasn't sure who was going to be here. So.
As vice chair, yeah. Does it matter?
You can.
Oh, it's
yeah.
Chairman.
Okay. Thank you. The I guess I have some questions. Mr. Waltz is here.
Sure.
Correct. Hi. Yep. I didn't see you walk out there.
And Mark is with me this evening as well.
Okay. I had some questions.
Who's here?
Mark Benchbach.
Oh, okay.
And these were just things that I heard after the meeting where the motion was rescinded to give him the buyer's assistance program. On a motion to rescind, votes cannot be rescinded after something's been done as a result of that vote that the assembly cannot undo.
Correct.
Meaning if the loan, you know, are you...
My loan was dependent upon this $10,000, and that contract was engaged after the May meeting and before the rescind. So that was that contract was engaged per that $10,000 being granted to me, and was relying on the $10,000.
So, I mean, and this is, you know, totally up to you all. You didn't listen to me at that meeting to do the motion to reconsider, but instead you did the rescission. And the exception to the motion to rescind is they cannot be rescinded when something's been done as a result of that vote. Basically, it's a reliance on that vote, and he went and got a loan on the reliance of that vote.
You have the documentation of that?
I have not received documentation of that.
I have it with me this evening. Would you like it?
Yeah.
See it? Let me see if I can pull it up here real quick. If not, I can pull it up on my phone. Right, let me just do that. It's the only paper I don't have printed off.
I just want this board to understand, just like somebody laid this list here for all those grants, it was given 34 units. Every one of those 34 is brand new construction.
Right.
So you're given... Now well, you're doing one that's not.
I apologize for being small, but my pre-approval letter from Friendship Stadium. And I have requested a copy of my application, which specifies $10,000. But my lending agent is out due to a family emergency this week and told me she'll get that to me first thing this coming.
And we did also bring, did give you guys copies of the Redevelopment Commission meeting minutes from 2009 when Mr. Bonchbach came and asked for more money. I think what had happened, as you explained, Mr. Rabbit, that there was the builder that went bankrupt and he came and asked for more money. at that time. He said at this time, Mark went over the size of the units and the selling price. He said if he can't sell the units, he would have to rent them and would be making payments to the city during the entire course of the loan. We did not find anything in the minutes where they said about the home buyer's assistance. That was only what Mr. Abbott remembered. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So that's the contract we're under right now, that he makes payments from the rent. That's the agreement.
Yeah, and he's been making his yeah. payments to the revolving loan fund. But
I've got a question. It says 90% loan of the appraised loan value.
Correct.
So what's the sell price for the apartment?
That is a topic, and I plan on discussing that with the loan committee. But Mr. Bunchbach needs about $125,000 per unit. It's yeah. really $124,000 some change. But correct, I am approved for 90% of the appraised value. So we will have
that
to
different than the 125?
It more than likely is going to be different. I have some comps here. Would you like to look at those as well?
Is there an appraised value on those buildings?
Has it been appraised?
I have not paid for an appraisal. Neither has he.
And you don't have a purchase agreement, I take it, since you don't even know what amount you're paying.
Correct. And the amount, what we would do is it would be a short sale, just like you would come to the bank, but the city is obviously the one that has the loan on at the loan committee, so we need to come and discuss that with the loan committee and figure out an actual fair market value to purchase that for.
So are you saying you don't want to pay the $125,000 for it?
I would like to pay the fair market value for the place. Okay. And if it does appraise for the $125,000, then that's the price that I'll pay. But if it appraises for less, that's the price that I would like to pay.
I'd say we'd go back to our original problem of Mr. Bunchbox needed to lease them out for a while until he could sell them to pay off the loan. And he's figuring on selling them for $125 each, right, in order to pay that loan off?
Because typically a short sale is to accept less money than is owed.
I owe $745,000 on 6 units.
Are you willing to sell that house to him for less than $125,000 and then make up the difference to the city of it?
I am not.
You are not.
But I'm also looking for the situation that occurred that devalued my property was based upon the condos that were built on Walnut Street. If you took the cost per square foot and sold the condos on Walnut Street for their construction cost break even, you would probably have to sell those for $350,000 to $400,000.
Yeah, but all we could sell them for was the appraised values, and that's what they were sold for.
Right, and I have those with me today.
So let me ask you a question, Mr. Munchbox. If let's say that the appraised value was $80,000.
Mm-hmm.
That would leave, 35,000?
35, it'd be like,
no. So would you, just say, so that 35, you would have to put on to divide that out over the rest of those condos.
You can't do that. No.
But I'm just walking.
Yes, that's true.
So you'd have to divide that cost out over the rest of those condos, or you'd have to be willing to pay that yourself.
Right. And they're not, everybody thinks there's so much money, and I'll tell you what, I'll give them to you. I just take them. I just take them, lump sum. And think about, don't get me wrong, the city has treated me very fair. I am not here in any kind of vengeance meaning. They helped me out when I got in trouble. I lost a lot of money on that job. I tore down a building that was 4 units. Lucky Harrell, Tim Harrell, his whole family lived there forever. I tore down a building that was netting me probably $30,000 a year in my pocket. That appraised at about $115,000. I tore it down to put these in there. Okay? I tore it down, threw that asset into this building, and now I'm walking away from it saying I want to break even. Because I did get it myself. I trusted a 40-year-old company to do what they said, except the day after I gave them the last check, they went bankrupt. What can I do?
Now, Mark, your recollection as far as at the time all of this, when you came back in 2009, do you remember anything about the buyer's assistance program being mentioned?
It was through Main Street, and yes, they told me it was there. We set up, it was one of the first projects, one of the first, it was that and the Fox property, was the two that kind of came in about the same time. And they had set that up, and I was promoting it and promoting it. But then when I'm sitting here offering 1,150 square feet with a 550 square foot basement, you know, and I'm $100, you know, $80, $90 a square foot, and these down here are going for $50 a square foot, what am I to do? I couldn't compete, and any condo market was going to go down on Walnut Street. And the other side of this too, granted, in the 5 years that I've had these, I've paid in taxes and in interest over $125,000. If I wouldn't have, if the city wouldn't have partnered with me on that, I think my taxes on the building before was $600 a year. Okay, I mean, it needed to come down. You know, the only person who would live in there was Lucky. You know, and I wouldn't tear it down while Lucky lived there, because that's all he lived. But, and so I'm just trying to find a way. I would like to build more and do it again. Okay, I've, you know, this loan does balloon in 16. You know, my goal is to try to help. So right now I've got, like Paul says, you know, I stuck my own money in this. I've got $100,000 plus invested into this property. Plus cost, I mean, when Top Quality sold materials to this place, it was a cost. So I have over that amount of money invested. And, but yet there's compensations that everybody that wants to build in Lawrence, in Cincinnati, in Lawrenceburg, to get compensated by land, by development, by this. I would like for you to consider the $10,000 home buyer, and a concession on the loan. And I know what the concession means to, as Mike, I mean, I you know, if we do it now, then what do we, you know, it's another can of worms, you know. So, but this man's pretty, he's an aggressive, smart, young professional. I've seen him since he was in the Maverick program that I mentored. This is the people you want in downtown Lawrenceburg, him and him. And we've got to find ways to make it work. Now, because, you know, I don't have the money to say, okay, I'm going to throw $30,000 a unit, you know, six, it's $180,000. I don't have that kind of money to do that. So what, where does this end picture look? What's it look like? I'm, you know, I can do what I can. I can go through them and fix them all up and make them perfect. But I think if there was, I think almost everybody in that unit would almost buy their unit if there was something other than $125,000. That's my fault, and it's my problem, and if you stick me with it, I'll just have to figure it out somehow.
Well, as far as reducing that amount, I think what you're saying on the loan, that's a different board.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Not,
well,
okay. Now, I have a question, though. Just say it sells for $100,000.
Mm-hmm.
Are you willing to pay that entire $100,000 on the loan?
I don't want anything.
Okay.
I'm ready to walk away. You know, I'm here. I pull the weeds down there. I have a professionally mowed. I have a professionally landscaped. That is a nice looking building. I don't care, you know, for what Lawrenceburg needs. You need, in my opinion, and I'm going to start going to some of the development meetings in town. You got, Lawrenceburg needs 500 units in downtown. Not ones and twos, and you need 500 units in downtown Lawrenceburg somewhere to get the economic development side to handle what businesses you want to be down here. Everybody says, well, we need the businesses, then they'll move down here. Hey, sorry, it don't work that way. You go up to Washington Park, they're building all these condos, and the retail is taking off. Okay, so we need more. And we've got to find ways to do more projects like mine, and hopefully I'm smarter and I've learned a little bit more. I'm getting old though, so it's getting harder. But that's you know, I'm here to do what you guys want. I think he has good points. I've listened to him. He is the most well-prepared person I've ever come across when it comes to having a debate. You know, I'm like, well, it's even my property, and he comes up with answers that I don't know. So I'd like for you to consider. One, at the minimum, is the $10,000. At one time, when it was with Main Street, it was $10,000, and then it kind of started morphosizing into percentages, like 10% up to $15,000. The original deal back then was no percentage, it was $10,000.
Well, I think there was a motion earlier made so we can find that out.
Yeah, I don't disagree. But I think
which part of the problem on this too, I mean, you need to get in front of the loan committee to even see about going forward. Because they're the ones that's going to have to make a decision about on the short sale, if they're going to take a loss or not.
For the past 3 months, we've been working on that, and we have a meeting on July 20th.
So the goal here is, I take my meetings, screwed it, messed up, or who's responsible for what, but is to get acceptance, to reestablish the, they've never been sold, so this would be new sales. Nobody's ever owned them prior. And they are townhouses. They're not apartments. They follow the exact same bylaws because I think I helped the bylaws when they did them for Lawrenceburgs. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah.
So
I think, well, it was Mr. Ewan. Yeah.
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 Well, he did mine. Didn't he? So, and they are individual townhouses. And we need to get, if you look at the parking, I mean, there's nice cars in the parking lot in there. It's a good place. Everybody feels safe. Everybody'd like to stay.
Okay. Mr. Waltz, did we not vote to give you this grant?
You did.
May?
Okay. Yes.
But you know, here's one problem I've got now that's just come up. When we voted for that, and then we rescinded it, they rescinded it the next meeting. But when we voted on that, we were being told you're buying it for $125,000. And we thought that was a good deal. You sell them, your loan's paid off, Mr. Bunchbox, and everybody's happy. But now I'm being told you don't want to pay $125,000 for it. So that kind of changes the ball game.
The original question that was asked was, how much did he need for it? How much was owed on the condo? I was never directly asked the question of what I was planning to pay for it, because the answer to that question is fair market value. But also, that's a discussion to have with the loan committee, and I didn't feel like it was a present conversation to have with redevelopment, because it was not the same as the $10,000 for this contract. With the $10,000, nowhere in there does it discuss the purchase price.
Well, since you brought up that point, Tony, because I was not at that meeting, I'm going to suggest to the board to table this till the next meeting, and every one of us review that tape of what was said.
Which one? Are you talking about the May?
Yeah.
Well, the May, we give him the grant, and then we voted to rescind it at the last meeting.
That was June.
After I had engaged in a contract. Yeah, but I have the minutes here from that meeting if you would like to review the motion.
I want to listen to the DVD, because minutes only has certain things.
Sure. I didn't speak at that meeting. I actually sat down. I did not speak. Correct.
I was also led to believe that you were buying for $125,000 and that was going to pay off his loan.
Who said that?
When he was asking for it. We were asking how much it was going for. Yeah. It was
$125,000. That meeting?
In the May meeting.
So did he speak in May?
I did not speak.
We'd need that much out each
year. In the May meeting?
Yeah.
You did come up in May. You asked for the...
Somebody said $125,000 because we're going
Grant
to...
Grant was the one that was speaking for me at that meeting, and I sat there. I was sitting on this side, three rows in, and I did thank you guys at the end, and that was it, and I just said that from my seat. But I did not formally get up and speak. And the motion that was passed was for the full purchase price goes towards the principal of the loan. It does not state what the full principal price is, so that's leaving X.
First of all, this board... can't state that. They can't
correct.
Vote on that.
It was contingent, I think.
Correct. That would be for the loan committee to decide on what the purchase price is, not for this board. I do understand that.
Could next time, could I have some paperwork, something with your something about what you're doing? I have nothing on this except rescinding a previous motion, A.J. Walls. I have no idea. I just like to have some paperwork.
Sure.
I mean, I came in here with nothing, and I have all this paperwork, and I haven't read a thing. Not one thing.
Yeah, I wasn't asked to prepare
it's
paperwork,
very,
but I can
very,
next time.
Disturbing for me.
Okay, I work on that for next time.
Connie, can you request a copy of the DVD for me? I don't know if anybody else wants
to.
Yeah, Please get out.
I'd like to, can I?
You can get to it.
All right.
Question.
Besides of AJ, okay, I'm still representative of six units. Okay, what I am asking from the board tonight is would you reinstate the $10,000 grant money towards the purchase of the condos from new buyers?
Let me ask a question.
Irrelevant of whatever deal AJ Waltz wants to do, I'm asking this as far as my, because I have other people and I want to start marketing and get this. I got to get them sold before the 2016.
Yeah. I've got a question about that. If we agreed to that, you would agree that for each person that bought, mm-hmm. the monies that went towards that would go down to pay the proportion amount you owe per unit. And so if all six sold, all six, the loan would be reduced by 100%.
Yes. I'm in total agreement because I'm selling them for one. If what we are saying and we're agreeing that if 745,000 divided by six is like 214 some change, that if I sold them for 124
yeah.
and some change, that
$124,166.
That's I'm looking to break even, guys. So that's the money. If you then I would have to the buyer would have to come in with 114,100 and that.
My concern.
And in that situation, all money goes to the city.
Here's my concern. Every time you sell a unit for less than the 124, I see a collateralization problem.
You and me both.
It's growing as that happens.
I can't get there.
It makes it
impossible for me. I cannot.
That's really a problem not for this board, but a problem for the loan company.
But I am not going to jeopardize my company financing real estate.
Yeah.
I can't take on any more debt.
Let me ask AJ a question. AJ, if we agreed to do the $10,000 and the appraised value came in at, say, $80,000, but we weren't willing to move off, the loan committee wasn't willing to move off the 125, are you willing to come up with the additional money of above and beyond the 90% loan to loan value?
So let me make sure that I'm getting the question correct. If it appraises for $80,000 and the loan committee puts a $10,000 dependent upon the $125,000 asking price. So basically you're asking me to come up with the $45,000 difference to get the $10,000. That wouldn't make sense because I would just pay my $10,000 on my own to get it down on there, which I wouldn't do, and I probably wouldn't be living down here or at least purchasing down here.
You gotta ask the question.
Right, because it all goes back to the loan committee. First of all,
right.
Whether it appraises for 50 or 110, if it's any less than what's owed on it, that loan committee is going to have to.
Right.
I kind of feel like this is kind of putting the cart before the horse in one sense.
Got a lady back
but,
here.
Hold on.
Well, but I'm looking. I understand your guys with him.
Right.
But I think.
What you're asking another question.
But the reality of it is, it should still be independent of him.
Right.
And
he should not be
asking this question of you. I should be asking it for my building on my project.
Exactly. Which my, hopefully you understand my concern, because just like I got a list here, 34 units, they're all brand new. When they got that money, it was for a brand new unit. No longer are those a brand new unit. So my concern is, can somebody come in and file a lawsuit because, hey, they won't give me $10,000 to buy a house over here on Center Street.
Mm-hmm.
But to give one for that property. That's my concern. Because last thing I want to see is Lawrenceburg get 25 lawsuits over.
I totally agree. But these have never been deeded other than the developer.
But they're still not brand new. I mean, they've been lived in.
I will make them brand new. I understand it's the semantics is me going through them and replacing everything in it or whatever it needs to be. Still does not.
That's my my concern.
Leslie, it's a valid concern. I will not say that. It's not. But I also know that we got to get people in downtown Lawrenceburg. And there are concessions that every house that has been built, a concession made, either in land or benefits.
34 of them.
34 of them. And I'm not asking for anything different. And so I'm just trying to.
The only thing I see, Tony, is that at the time that they were built, he'd intended to sell them. At the time they were built, the commission was going to give them the $10,000 assistance program. Because he couldn't sell them and instead had to rent them, that's my problem. I mean, I understand what Mike is saying. I completely agree. They're not any longer new units. But this was the same time that the Fox property and then we followed with giving the $10,000 to everybody on Walnut Street. And yeah, they were new.
Nobody ever lived in them. That's my concern.
But that's my concern.
Nobody lived in them.
Are we setting ourselves up for lawsuits, or is it all right for us to do this because these houses have never been deeded out yet? Because they're still considered new, because there's never been a deed to them.
I don't know that in town, if, and someone can correct me if I'm wrong, if this would apply to anybody else in town.
Well, there's got to be somebody's name on a deed. There's got to be a deed.
It's right. They're my. It's
right. I mean,
the development.
I have a question. If the balloon payment comes due and you're not able to pay it, I guess the city forecloses on that, and then we're the owners of these six units. And at that point, we have to try to sell them or do something with them, and we're probably not going to get anywhere near the 125. So we're going to lose. My objective: try to get our damn money back.
Well, I agree, and I want to find a way to get that back to you. I've thought of trying to get creative, whereas you don't take a loss, you don't set a precedent, you give forgiveness. Let's say they lived there for 5 years, and at the end of 5 years, you get a forgiveness loan, like they did on the, like Main Street was doing on the signs and the building repairs. If you put so much money in, then I was just trying to get creative on it. I think because there is minutes stating that this was a project early on, and that, you know, the impact of not being able to sell was due to factors outside of my control. And if you remember back then too, that's when the mortgage crisis hit. And it came back too that banks were not going to loan money on condos anymore. FHA loan. They would loan it on a conventional basis, which means it's a 20% down payment. But you couldn't get an FHA loan on a house that was greater than or less than 80% down, unless, because what happens is if the first bank loans the money on it and then other banks loan after that, the first bank that actually gave the loan is accountable for the rest of the building. And Friendship is now stating that, hey, we're interested in this, we'll give a loan on this building.
So I've got something that I want to suggest. It seems like to make a decision on your request of $10,000 may or may not cause us some legal exposure. We don't know the answer to that. Is that fair to say?
Well, I mean, it would just depend on if someone were to bring it.
Okay, so we don't know the answer to that. We also don't know if you're going to be interested once this thing fleshes out with the loan committee. So why would we vote on an issue tonight that may not be an issue if you go through the loan committee and you decide that's not worth it for you?
Well, two reasons. One is you're trying to reinstate this for all six units per Mark's request. But secondly is I only have 60 days on my pre-approval letter. That was in May. At the start of that, I requested a loan committee meeting, and I just got it granted this past Monday for the 20th of July. So unless we're going to have one within the next 2 days after that, I won't be able to stay in my pre-approval. I'll have to go back through that process to get pre-approval, get dinged again on my credit score for yet a fourth time, and then start back at square one. Where right now I'm trying to get this in place, and I was trying to get the loan committee prior to this, and there was no loan committee, and here we are 3 months later, and this just happened to be the order of the meetings.
Well, here's something that, because, I mean, I think you read a law that, you know, if you enter into something, can't get out of before.
Is there just the Roberts rules?
It was told right here, but there's no purchase agreement. So you can get out of, all he's is has a pre-approval letter from a bank. He has no purchase agreement. So, first of all, that law doesn't stand because there is no purchase agreement.
I would disagree with that.
You would?
Because my pre-approval is based upon that $10,000 for that, and it didn't matter which.
You have no purchase. You don't have a purchase agreement on a piece of property. You can't even tell us how much.
We have an agreement.
We have a handshake, and he gave me a dollar.
Can't even tell me. No. Okay, Mark. Anyhow, you couldn't even stand there and tell us how much you're paying for it.
Because that question hasn't been answered yet.
If I enter into a purchase agreement on a home, it has to say how much I'm purchasing it for. It can't say open.
But I'm pre-approved based on that amount. And when you read the contract that I was given for the grant, it states that it's for new home purchases. So I'm purchasing a new home, so I was counting on that $10,000. It doesn't specify where in Lawrenceburg it was. So when I went to the bank and I presented them with this, that's based upon this $10,000. For my pre-approval
for the new home,
so.
And they called me.
I'm a new home buyer. That's the language that was written in here.
I don't have a problem with, as long as legally it didn't come back and bite us. I wouldn't have a problem giving the $10,000. The problem I have is, I don't know the answer to that question. I'm not an attorney. I'm not going to pressure Leslie to give us a firm answer on that here, but. So. My thing is, I don't want to go through something that may or may not be a legal risk to this board if at the end of the loan meeting you may walk away from the whole thing. And here we have voted on something tonight that may not even be an issue. I think that process needs to happen first to see if you're even interested. And if you are, and the money that you have to come up with, then you come back before this board.
I
agree, but I'm still interested.
Let me ask.
I have my own separate agenda.
Well, no, and I agree,
and I understand that. But if we want to get like I'm treated at council meetings, you're not on the agenda. So,
let me ask this, Mark.
Sure.
Are you actually allowed to sell any of those for less than $124,000? I mean, doesn't the loan committee have to sign off on those homes?
Oh yeah.
So they will not sign off for anything less than the $124,000.
Well, they might, but this isn't the loan committee board, so we don't know.
But wait a minute.
The board would have to
vote. As Mike said earlier,
I'm not sure the development agreement says that.
All we're looking for is discussion on $10,000. Does the project qualify or does it not?
And I really think that's going to be the board's interpretation at this point. Like you said, we don't have any written policy on how. I mean, even the name of the program is subject to.
So there is no written policy?
No, not besides the application. There's no written policy. I mean, that's what Owen was saying before.
Well, I thought that was part of the motion to get what's in writing to review.
What's in writing, as far as I know, is the application.
Yeah, the application is the only thing in writing.
So, you know, at this point, I believe it's up to the board. It's going to be up to the board. It's not. It's going to be a decision of the board, not something whether we're following something or not following something. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, we're just going to have to look historically and try to treat everybody the same.
Is it possible, Les, that someone could come back? Let's say that Dennis builds a house, lives there. Year from now, he wants to sell it. Somebody wants to come get $10,000 homeowner's money to buy that house.
Well, as long as we make if you're talking about Mr. Hutchins in particular, I mean, as long as we make.
As an example, I mean,
as a purchase contract.
I think what he's saying, if somebody builds a house over here, lives in it a year, they go to sell it. Those people come to this board, ask for $10,000. The board says no. Can that person sue this board because he got it for a used one or somebody else got it for a used one?
So but what I'm asking is two things. That the ambiguity be removed from these agreements,
right,
and to get a legal opinion on whether we're exposing ourselves, because I'm risk adverse. I'm not a risk taker when it comes to money, especially public money.
And if you wanted to use these as an example, you could say first time, you know, first deeded owner from the development.
See, in first time,
there's nobody else that's in that, nobody else that would be coming to buy an existing house if it was, you know, another house somewhere on Arch Street that already has a prior.
For you. I mean, it could apply to Mr. Seymour. I could see that applying to Mr. Seymour. He built the house he wants to build on 2.5 acres. He wants, and he's the developer, you know. So, you know, anyone that would want to buy, you know, I could see. But I agree with Mr. Clausen. I do think, you know, however the board wants to proceed, the way you can proceed is to do a motion to rescind your motion to rescind. If you want to table that, that's, you know, that's totally up to you. But I do think doing a work session or something to come up with set standards, you know, that everyone can follow and not deviate
from.
Well,
my point again is we're being asked to make a decision here that may or may not have consequences. So we're taking a risk. And then he goes before the loan committee and they say, no, we're not doing that. He says, well, never mind, I don't want the house. Then why? I'm not willing to take the risk until I know whether or not I got a buyer.
Well, I guess why would I take a risk? Special meeting on the 21st or 22nd of July would be the way to do that. It's the 20th.
And following that scenario, do I need to get on next month's agenda so that I can present the request on my behalf?
If we're going to have some legal advice by then.
Could I be added to next month's agenda?
Please, Connie.
To discuss the home purchase, what is it?
Home assistance
program application for Lucky Square. They even named it after him.
Yeah.
They got a Grant, you got something over there?
No, I was finished. I want to go back to a point with AJ, but go ahead and finish where you were headed with.
Well, I make a motion we table this till we all get a look at the original agreement for the home assistance.
Along with the DVD?
Along with
the May meeting?
Yes.
Have a motion on the floor. Do we have a second?
Second.
First and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
No, I'm opposed.
Okay, roll call, please.
Tom Rogers?
Yes.
Olin Clausen?
No.
Tony Bryant?
Yes.
Tony Abbott?
Yes. We know what we're doing. I don't think we can do anything.
I'd like to explain my vote. I voted no because I think that until this goes before the loan committee and they get a determination whether or not they're willing to budge, it seems like a moot point to me.
I agree with it.
But, you know, AJ, we want you downtown. We do.
Appreciate that.
Like I said, I've been sitting here for 20 years, and the laws and it always seems to come, and I hope with you it doesn't come back on us. That I want to give you that $10,000, you know, even to get you down here. But it just seems that the lawyers come at us, and we don't win too many. We really don't.
I agree with that.
Bill Earth was the last one.
AJ, I got the same feeling. We our contracts are just—they're not up to par.
And I want to go.
And I've stated it in a public meeting that I think I could write a better one than some of these that's out there.
I agree. I agree.
I do want to go on record that I don't have a problem with the $10,000 either.
I understand your point as well.
None of us do.
Sure.
We would love to give it to you, but we just don't know whether we can.
Sure.
And we're within your timeframe, right, with this
meeting?
Right.
If we go, yeah, if we go right out, we're doing this on the 21st, is that it?
I don't know. That will be up to the board.
Yeah, if we have a meeting for the $10,000 the next day, like 21st, 22nd, I should be good on that. Like I said, my loan person I'm working with, she's out on a family emergency right now, and I have an email requesting the application. Plus, I asked for an extension of a week on that. Just so that way we have a little bit of buffer room as well. So I don't know if that's granted yet or not.
20.
At 5.
Is everybody available for the 21st of July?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Is 5 o'clock okay with everybody?
Oh, I'm here.
You'll be here, Tom. You got a lot of years left. 5 o'clock, okay?
Yep.
5 o'clock on July 21st.
I'm good.
Got it. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Have a good night.
Grant.
If Your Honor, point of clarification.
Sure.
And, AJ, when we originally talked about this, it was 125 that was being discussed at that time.
When you and I discussed it, or?
When you first contacted me about it, and we were talking about the 125. It wasn't until
recently
that I knew that you were going to do an appraisal,
right,
There was a difference in issue. So that's where the 125 did come from, and I have stated that in the meeting, Tony.
Yeah, and I think that was clarified as well, that 125, that's what was owed on that meeting, or on it as well, that Mark wasn't trying to profit off of it.
Right.
That was what was owed.
Mark wasn't trying to profit. He'd turn over 100% of it. That's where it got to start.
Yes.
That's what made us all interested, because it would eventually pay the whole loan off.
Right.
Right.
Because it could be all moot if Lawrenceburg doesn't sign off. Lawrenceburg Loan Committee doesn't even sign off on it. Yet they don't allow Mark to sell it for any less
than that. Right, correct. And then like Olson said, too, if it forecloses on it, then they're stuck with them at market value. So hopefully we can work with Loan Committee on it.
And
see you guys
on 21st. One other thing. This is just a side point. Since he started this, I've been contacted by other people who are interested. They happen to be young people also. And I believe you told me at one time two of your friends are interested.
Two more interested in them as well. So,
it looks like it's something that we, as a board, need to be looking at. If it's not this project, some project. So, thank you.
Move on to Grant, Main Street Association / George Jones.
Yes, at our last meeting, there was some discussion regarding the $15,000 going to Euthemia and Arch Street, and in particular Arch, which is the potential buyer there, or the buyer is George Jones. And discussion evolved to the point of, well, was our money in escrow? What's going on? The word construction loan got thrown around, and there was some concern from the board as to how are we putting our money up on a construction loan, and what's our securities in that. In your packet is a letter from UCB with explanation, and I also have Jim Kittle is here to answer any questions regarding that. It's pretty important that we get this cleared tonight, because they're ready to close the one loan on getting this thing started. So with that said, Mr. Kittle.
I mean, I'll answer any questions you have, but let me kind of walk through the process, and I'm going to get these numbers close, but I don't want to discuss Mr. Jones's personal financial information in a public meeting, but I'll walk through it. Mr. Seymour is going to build Mr. Jones a house on a lot that he got from the city, and I'll say $155,000. Nice house, 1,600 square feet garage. We've granted him a loan, I'll make it up, for $100,000. So he's going to build it for $155,000. We grant him a loan for $100,000. The city is going to grant possibly this $15,000. So now he's got $140,000. He's got a $40,000 down payment. So when we close, we're going to be in control. UCB will be in control of a whole $155,000. They're not, the borrowers aren't going to touch the money. They need the money to give to us to complete the house. So we're going to be in control of the money. We'll make sure the house gets built. To me, it's an opportunity to get a new house started, and then Paul's going to start another house with nobody. He's going to build another market house, nobody interested. So he'll have two houses going side by side. And also, I sat through Dennis's 45-minute presentation. It's a beautiful house. I couldn't imagine the city not thinking a beautiful home like that. You couldn't build, I can't remember how many square feet, you couldn't get a 2,000 square foot house on a 40, I guess you could build it three stories high possibly, but I think it's a beautiful home for downtown. I think we, when I say we, but I would think the city would be interested in anyone building $200,000 house downtown.
I think I want to make myself clear now. I think you're referring to my objection, but what my objection was to the whole thing was, you know, our paperwork and our contracts and our original agreements, we never offered it to everybody else.
Right.
That's my concern. The home is beautiful.
Right.
I'd love to see a whole Lawrenceburg like that.
Right.
But we need to get things in order and do everybody the same way. That was my only concern.
Let's let Jim finish it.
But really, we're going to be in control of the money. The house will get built. You know, I think it's... Yeah,
and there's only one closing. There's not.
Oh, yeah, there's only one closing. 6 months interest only. It's a seventh month. It converts into P&I. There's not going to be two closings or anything. People are going to sign a note. I made this up for $100,000. You know. They have plenty of, to me, it's another opportunity. These folks are coming from Aurora, want to come downtown Lawrenceburg. I think it's a great opportunity to pick up.
How's it different, Jim? And I really don't understand. How's it different than the way we did it before? And we gave the home buyer that $10,000 to help with their down payment. Are they coming up at 20%?
They're coming up with more than 20%.
Okay, well, that's what this $10,000 was supposed to be for, to help them come up with that more than 20%.
Well, he said now, they're only borrowing $100,000.
Is it still?
Yeah, I mean, they're coming up with a lot more. They're coming up with a lot more. And again, I don't want to talk. Please don't talk about my personal information. I'm not going to talk about theirs or yours.
I'm not talking about anybody's personal information.
Yeah,
I'm just talking about a home buyer that we're going to give $10,000 or $15,000 to help them pay for the down payment of the house they're buying.
That's right.
Okay, for their loan. So are they coming, do they have to come up with this full 30% or whatever it is now?
Would they have to?
Without this, are they paying the full 30%, or is this $10,000 going towards their 30% they're paying down on it?
They're paying 30% down, and you're giving them 10, we'll say 10 grand. So yeah, they're coming up. They got more skin in the game. Now you have someone that's really got some skin in the game. You have people buying houses over there, guys, that you're giving them $10,000 and they're getting PMI loans with no money down. These people got a lot of money on the line. Man. Yeah, your assistance, it's helping them.
Okay.
Yeah, it's.
Point of clarification, that'd be $15,000, not 10.
Yeah, 15.
Yeah, 15, 10, whatever.
Just to make sure.
We're throwing imaginary numbers around.
Right, well, I'm pretty close, so I didn't miss it too far.
Well, I think I'm the one that probably raised the concern about the $15,000 in the last meeting, and the reason being is there wasn't any real clarification on who was in charge of that money.
Right.
And, you know, I visualized a construction loan that would terminate and that would have to find a home for the permanent mortgage. And so that's where my concern
right.
was, to have some guarantees on our $15,000 investment.
Yeah.
This was different than what was done before. But, I mean, reading through the document, what you're explaining, my concerns, I don't have any concerns.
Yeah.
Anybody else?
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I thought this was going to be the long part of the meeting.
That's going to be the short part. We're going to skip right over there.
Any comments from the audience? Go ahead. Let's have Mr. Davis, sir.
John Davis. I think I expressed some of the concerns about that construction, that $15,000, same as Olin did, and we just want to make sure that if the money's being passing through Main Street, that we, there's an understanding of this board how we're to do it, so that there's something in writing, because I think I've had the same issue with some of the agreements and contracts, and looking to make sure that rate's fair. I mean, are these grants designed for new home buyers, or is it for new home purchases? That's not clear either.
What as far as, you're the board that administering, do you have any kind of policies as far as this program?
No, actually, this is a pass-through policy from the city to Main Street, and basically, when we have a closing, like, for instance, Friday, we've got a closing that I have to be at UCB at 9 o'clock in the morning, okay. So we can sign the check, which will be basically issued at that point when the closing is completed. So that's kind of unusual, too, because usually we just get the check after the closing us there, but there we're going to be present on Friday to do that. But I want to make sure whatever the board instructs us to do, and because again, I'm adverse to risk myself, so I want to make sure that the board understands how this is being done, because this is a little different than just doing a $10,000 or $15,000 loan at the closing. This is something that's done in advance. I assume, Jim, that money is safe for the city. I mean, if that house doesn't close for whatever reason, the city gets back that money. If that's
But we won't close unless we get the 15 grand. So yeah, it's safe.
Okay,
we're
so
not
if
gonna close without it, you're going to come with that $15,000 to our closing.
No, I'm talking about this one for the construction loan.
Yeah,
the advance.
Yeah, same way.
Okay,
safe.
All right.
And
I'll make sure that's clear. Well, I know, but again, I'm worried about the city's money too. So anyway, that's rich. The other thing is on AJ's thing, because we're talking about the devaluation, and I understand how you want to get the most money you can out of these loans. I think Mike, it might have been you that brought up when talking about how do we take care of these loans that are still outstanding with the city, and that's when you brought in three different banks to come into the city to do a presentation, and all the banks, I think, all came from different places. They weren't quite 100% sure exactly what you wanted them to present that evening, but it turned out basically it was like you're saying, if we could get 60 to 70% back to the city on those loans, we would probably consider something like that. What they came back with was something completely opposite, was we really don't want much to do with any of these loans, but we can give you some consultation and advice, and then recommended the hiring of an outside party to look at these loans. So the devaluation of this property, from Mark's standpoint or from AJ's standpoint, this is something the city is already ready to reconsider so they can recover these loans.
But that's a different board.
It is a different board. I understand. But I'm saying that the precedent is there that you were willing to consider it. And I know you have to get that part straightened out, too. But anyway, I don't have a problem with the construction loan as long as this board instructs us in what we should be doing, because I don't want to have any fallout here or fallout with Main Street, because we're usually a target. So we just want to do it the right way.
All right. Paul?
Thank you. A couple things, and it happened so far and few between, but we have done two other construction loans, so that's not the first time we've done that. But out of all the property, I mean, it's just two, so it doesn't happen very often that you get people come along that doesn't need the help. Clarification on one thing, when I made the proposal, I thought it was always, hey, we really appreciate you coming to Lawrenceburg and wanting to live here. Thank you for building a house in Lawrenceburg. It's never been, we knew that it would help people get a down payment, but when it was put together and talked about in the beginning, it was a thank you. We were looking for older people, and if you're going to look for older people, you know you're moving people in that do have financial stability. So the one thing I would like you to think about is it was always a thank you for coming to Lawrenceburg and wanting to live here. You've done a construction loan before, and the other thing, something good has happened over at the Fox property in the last week and a half. I don't think you're going to have the problem that everybody, you've got another issue that you don't know about yet that might not be a problem. There's been two houses that sold over on the Fox property. The one house, the two people got nice jobs. Their family's getting bigger. They want something better. These were starter homes, and they're ready to move on. They didn't take a hit. Everybody in town's been worried. Can you sell houses or are you going to take a hit? Guess what? They did fine on it. One on a corner, another one did fine on it. There's other areas in this county that went in and bought, built new homes, and these people bought these homes, and they're selling them for $30,000-$40,000 less than what they bought them for. So keep your fingers crossed, because if there's an appraiser done on, appraisal done on those places over there, you might not have that issue. They might actually be okay on the appraisal. You don't know that factor yet either.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thanks, ma'am.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Terry Waltz. I'm AJ's mom. That's my other name. I just had a couple questions for you, just so I'm clear on all this, so when he talks to me, I know what, how to answer or whatever. Okay, one thing, and I understand exactly where you guys are coming from on all this, and of course I know where he's coming from. I have one couple questions. One, I know you were kept saying, well, the $10,000, we agreed at the May meeting to give you the $10,000 based on the $125,000 purchase price. I don't understand what the purchase price has to do with. The purchase price is the loan committee, the other board. You guys are the ones that say yay or nay to the $10,000. So what does the purchase price have to do with the $10,000?
I'll answer that.
Okay.
I mean, the way I see it, because other ones, it's 10% up to a max.
Other ones. But this one was done in 2009 when they first came out, they said.
No, they wasn't approved for that in 2009.
Okay.
Or we wouldn't be standing here today. I mean, we're here today for this reason, but...
I don't know you can say they weren't, Mike. I mean, we weren't
well,
there.
Let's say the money was put in there for it in 2009,
but
they weren't sold in 2009.
Right.
Okay.
And back then, it was $10,000 flat, didn't depend on the price. But if it's, so you're telling me if based on today's thing, it would be the 10%, right?
Well,
so
I mean,
you're saying
be,
as long as it's 100,000 to 125, he could get $10,000 to $12,500 back.
My problem is, like I've said many times, is the new. That's my issue with it.
Right. I'm talking about when you guys approved it in May.
I wasn't at the May meeting. I was not here.
Okay. When it was approved in May, the rest of you, okay, well, I guess what I'm hearing right now, though, is that, again, because you kept saying, we approved the $10,000 because the price was $125,000. And I still don't understand why.
That's not just the deciding factor. I mean, that was one thing that would help me to approve it, because the city would recoup their money where he's going to sell them for $125,000.
That the loan committee's concerned about.
But we're still
your redevelopment.
Still part of the city.
Okay, I understand that.
I have concerns for the whole city, and that way we could write this loan off that Mr. Bunchbox had. Everybody was going to be happy. He got $10,000. City got their money. Mr. Bunchbox sold his property.
So if he buys it,
part of the consideration. You're right. The $10,000 was there in the beginning. They were not sold in the beginning. So he came and asked if that was still available. And this board thinks it's still available. That's what we voted on.
So regardless, though, let's say the loan committee says, you know, okay, yeah, we'll lower it, blah, 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 just to sell it. You give us 100% to mark, all that. But the price ends up being $90,000. Then he comes to you saying, okay, here it is. Do I still get my $10,000? Are you going to say, well, it wasn't $125,000, so no? What I don't understand,
I think
where the division is, I guess. You guys are the ones that say yay or nay to the $10,000.
I think that will have to be looked at that next meeting when it's voted upon.
Okay, but you guys need to figure out what you're going to do. I mean, you guys, like you keep saying, you need to have the rules. You need to have something in writing so you're consistent.
Right.
I'm taking what everybody's saying. So you're consistent with everybody. So you're going to have to decide if the purchase price depends if on that, regardless who owns the loan or whatever.
Who said about it needs to be in writing, and who was
talking
to?
You guys have all been saying this needs to be in writing. But.
And I'm going to make my point of I think there's been a VOTOL sitting in this chair for 12 years now, and they're the ones that was here. I haven't seen it in writing. And I think it should have been.
Yeah, it should be in writing.
Day one.
And you're saying the only thing in writing, I guess, Ms. Votal, is the application itself.
That's right.
And what does the application say? Where are we getting the words new home buyer, or what are the words?
And even looking in 2009, that was what the assistance program was called when it started.
New home buyer.
It was new home buyer assistance.
Okay. And see, that's where you get your ambiguity.
Right.
Is it a new home or is it a new buyer? Is the home an adjective for the word buyer?
Right. Exactly. Exactly.
So that's where you get this whole thing, your ambiguity.
Adjective.
Is it a
new
home?
I asked whether it was an adjective last month.
Yeah. So.
And you bring up a good point, and I would like to know who originally wrote that.
Yeah. Whoever did. never mind. Anyway. And then I also. I had a lot of questions while you guys were all talking because I kept thinking, well, that doesn't make sense. But my other thought is, you know, you could make $5,000 right here now because he gave you $15,000, and then you could give him $10,000. And look, you're $5,000. I'm done.
Thank you. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Mike, can we have a meeting that ain't going to
I can see it's going to happen, whatever they want to do.
I'm glad you
can trust me.
Hey, bags with your lawyers.
Yeah. We all get bashed.
I'm going to do it since that episode.